about the first pediatrician hired by a city agency anywhere.
I think that's correct. I think that is completely correct, and I think it was a very, very smart move on the part of Denver to do that. Very often, I would go with the social worker to see the child and evaluate the situation in the first place, which I think was very helpful. I prevented a lot of people from being really accused of child abuse, when in fact it wasn't child abuse, it was something else. But one of the things that I accomplished while I was there was the help of this committee that was formed to try to make things better, work better in the child protection world, and that was that they created a special hotline and a special immediate response system. If someone called and said, I think this child's been abused, someone went out within an hour, almost immediately. And so that was a big help to everyone. Eventually, we had a crisis center. The crisis center was instead of these police receiving homes, and all the children came there first. And that meant that I could examine them. And we had children who were extremely disturbed, which didn't show up until you had them there for 24 hours, you know? So it gave us a chance to have the children settle down and feel reasonably safe, and then they could be interviewed to see what was going on. And I think it was a very good system. The truth is a relative thing. And sometimes children don't tell the truth because they don't want to get their parents in trouble. Much more likely than that they accuse their parents of wrongdoing when it didn't happen. Kids are very protective of their parents, and they're very, really, they don't want trouble. Taking them away from their natural parents, even though they're awful people, very often I think is very hurtful to the children. But other children are just, I want to go home. Well, but they mistreated you, they abused you, they sexually abused you, they beat you, they etc. Well, I'm used to that, and I love them anyway, and I want to go home. So it's a difficult business. Interestingly, I had up to 38 people by myself in there sometimes. First of all, I think a lot of people can't handle anger in other people. These people were very angry. They were angry at the court for sending them there. They were angry at the social worker. They were angry at the system. They were angry at life because life had been so bad for them. I tried. I really learned a lot from them. I learned how miserable their lives really were. Not many people have written about neglect. And I got very interested in neglect because I think it's been very much ignored. Everybody wants to talk about child abuse and sexual abuse. And I did write one of the early contribution to child sexual abuse, and I wrote the chapters in many books on neglect. So I think the judges really needed to hear that, not to ignore issues of neglect, that really children who are neglected very often, mm-hmm. The problem is that nobody talks to them, nobody teaches them manners, nobody teaches them how to be. Having tried, I think, is what we should all do, and that's what I did. I tried very hard to contribute. I think that there's no reason not to start a new career and a new path when you're in your 50s or 60s. It's a good time because I think you're less vulnerable in a way. You've been through a lot. You know, I've often said that people become what their neurotic trait dictates. My neurotic trait, I think, is to want to help people. And that's why you become a doctor. You want to help somebody, you know, you want to make them better, want to make them feel better. So my neurotic trait is what led me to do this. So I think people need to sort of look at what it is that matters to them and what makes them feel like they need to do. But the main thing, I think, is that whatever it is you set out to do, try to do it well. And don't be casually sloppy about what you're trying to do. Do it well and do the research and do look into it and try to get it yourself educated to do the job well.